أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, عاشوراء, the 10th of المحرم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you fast that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your previous year. MashaAllah. From all minor sins will be forgiven, inshaAllah. If you fast tomorrow. From Sunnah, if you would like to do that, more ajr, inshaAllah. If you fast today and tomorrow, or you fast tomorrow with 11th, which is day after tomorrow, التالي يعني. And also 13, 14, 15th of the Hijr calendars also from Sunnah to fast, if you can fast, means this day, this week, mashallah, most of the days. And from Sunnah to fast mostly in the month of Muharram, يعني. This up to you, it's optional, but it's more ajr, inshallah. The minimum, fast tomorrow. If you fast tomorrow, inshallah, you will be forgiven, inshallah, for 1 year, previous year. I get a question yesterday from one of my shaykh about Surah An-Nas, last chapter in the Holy Quran. He sent me a message on WhatsApp, and shaykh, what is the meaning of tafsir of this ayah? Min al-jinnati wal-nas. Last two words in the Holy Quran, Surah An-Nas. He said, we know that, the shaytan is giving secret talks and whispers to the people. Why Allah mentioned innas here? Innas means people too. Is there any relationship between the shaytan and people? Let's see Surah An-Nas and then we'll give you the explanation of that. Surah An-Nas, the last surah in the Holy Quran, 114, 6 verses. And the hidayat of this surah, or the merits of this surah, it's giving us message. The message of Surah An-Nas, seeking refuge of Allah Azza wa Jal, the King of mankind. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. And it was the question of the Shaykh, what is the meaning مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. We know the shaitan is our enemy, and he's giving secret talks, and he's making all of this kharab around the world. What about the nas? Is there any shayateen from the human being? Of course. طيب, let's see. From the evil whispers of the humans and jinn, both, they are working together. I'll give you the ayat now. Those whom are whispering in the chest and the hearts of mankind. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I give a title here before first ayah. The necessity of seeking refuge with Allah from the evil of jinn and humans. يعني say أعوذ بالله. أعوذ بالله means this seeking refuge. أعوذ بالله, I seek refuge. I seek refuge, يعني you're telling Allah, Ya Rab, I am very weak, please help. This is the meaning of أعوذ بالله. أعوذ بالله from what? من الشيطان الرجيم. Right? I seek refuge with Allah from الشيطان. Means, Ya Rab, take care of this shaitan because I don't have any capability to stand against him. This is the meaning of أعوذ بالله من الشيطان. That's why Allah said, whenever you start the Quran recitation, Allah said, فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. عليه. استعذ بالله, because the shaitan want to disturb you. It doesn't want you to read Quran. Sometimes when you read Quran to someone, you say, you start yawning and start tearing, a lot of tears, yawning, and they start sleeping. Because shaitan, he doesn't want him to listen to the Quran. He want to disturb him. فإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. سيعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Yeah. طيب. He said, say, Prophet Muhammad, قل. قل means يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Say. And to have too many قلز in the Quran. قل. قل. يعني deliver it to the people the way I show it to you. The way I give it to you. Don't invent. Don't say something from your mind. قل. You say it. You just deliver it. قل. Say, oh Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, I seek refuge with Allah, the Lord and the Lord of mankind, the King of mankind, who is self-sufficient and has the control of all their affairs. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس إله الناس ملك الناس, the King of mankind, is self-sufficient, has all control of our life and our affairs. Malik al-Nas. Ilah al-Nas, the only God to be worshipped by all mankind. Ilah al-Nas. Subhanallah. Said, قُلْ عَذُبْ رَبِّ النَّاسِ رَبِّ النَّاسِ Subhanallah. Said, al-Nas, everybody, Muslim and non-Muslim, kafir and mu'min. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, رَبِّ النَّاسِ That's why, subhanallah, still people are disobeying Allah. Even the, some of them, they are denying Allah completely, the atheists. They are denying Allah. They said, there is no God. And he's still feeding them. He's still taking care of them. Why? Because he is رَبِّ النَّاسِ. He is still their Rabb. I gave example before. If you have 9 kids or 10 kids, and one of them, kharban. MashaAllah, 9 of them, they are good. MashaAllah, good kids. Good in the school, they're doing everything good. They are very polite. They come to the masjid. Except one of them, he's all the time in the bar, drinking alcohol. SubhanAllah, teasing women. He's kharab, he's giving you problem every day. SubhanAllah, he's a troublemaker. If somebody asks you how many kids you have, are you going to say 9 or 10? He's still your son. What can he do? The same thing, Allah, the one who created this being, he's still their God. Rabb al-Nas. He did not say Rabb al-Mu'mineen or al-Muslimin. Al-Nas, all mankind. He's still feeding, taking care of them because he's still their Rabb. He's a creator. He's the one who created them. He did not create us and throw us in the middle of nowhere. The only God to be worshipped, Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, by all mankind. To seek refuge with Allah from the evil of the whisperer, the shaitan. The shaitan, whom whispers in the hearts of people when they forget Allah. Shaitan, when the shaitan can control you and can whisper into your heart, when you forget Allah. That's why he said in Surah Al-Hashr, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهِ فَأَنْسَهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ Don't be like those who forget about Allah and Allah, let them forget themselves. And more you will be away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more shaitan gonna have control in you. Gonna have control to whisper into your heart. You are the one who opened the windows. You are the one who opened the doors for the shaitan. Because you did not protect yourself. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you go to bathroom, say this dua. When you get out from the bathroom, say this dua. You're not supposed to talk in the bathroom. See, our kids nowadays, they are dumb, stupid. You see that kid? He has a cellular phone and he's sitting in the bathroom for 4 hours. And when they, what are you doing? I'm coming. And shaitan, they are playing in their mind. Wallah, don't let your child stay in the bathroom more than the time he used the bathroom. That's it. Otherwise, get out. What are you doing? Wallahi, yeah, wallahi, Azim. One time, I don't want to tell secret to people, but I don't mention names. This family, Muslim family, they came from far away to me with a kid like 15 years. He stayed 7 hours and 5 hours in the bathroom. Sometimes at night, he stayed in the bathroom. Wallahi al-Azim. And we've been talking, and he was telling him, why you do that? And his dad just interfering, telling him something, and he slapped his face like this, the face of his dad. I was about to take this kid to carry him from the window to throw him like this. Wallahi al-Azim. Imagine that his dad is in his height. The face of his dad, wallahi al-Azim. I said, why? Because his dad is telling him, Sheikh, talk to the Sheikh. Sheikh is asking you, why stay in the bathroom for 5 hours? He's taking his phone and he's talking. The shayateen, they are playing together inside. That's why, you know, these people, there. Rasulullah is giving us adab, and the Quran said, seek refuge, seek protection, be careful, shaitan is your enemy. And these kids, they have no information. They think they know everything. They look at somebody like me. You're old man, you don't know. You are radical, you know? You don't know nothing. We know better than you are in America. We study. We study a dumb too. The same thing you're studying, we study more than that in our countries before we come here. What do you think, يعني? We are not coming, يعني. We're a gamusa, يعني. Allah khrib beta. You're a buffalo. We don't know nothing, you know? And they think, يعني, wallahi, they think they know everything. These kids, they have to change their mentality. Wallahi, we are smart. We are smart too. We study too. Subhanallah. يعني very important to give this information. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, you are the one who opened the doors, the windows to the shaitan. I'm going to read this part again for you. From the evil of the whisperer, the shaitan, whom whispers in the hearts of people when they forget Allah and withdraws when they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Last ayah, or the one before last ayah, whom whispers evil and throws doubts in chest of mankind. Yeah, but the job of the shaitan to put doubts in the heart of people. Doubts about Allah, doubts about the Quran, doubts about Islam, doubts about the deen. And somebody being controlled too much with shaitan, first thing he's gonna say, I don't believe in Allah. I see to them, too many of them. Yes, first thing he's gonna talk about, I don't believe in Allah. There is no religion, there is no Islam, there is no deen. And exactly like Utba or Shaybar or Abu Jahl in Mecca, they used to say the same thing. Who deny Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they knew Muhammad is, he grew amongst them. They knew him. But khalas, the shaitan is in control now. He said, from among the jinn and mankind. طيب, what is the relationship now? This was the question of the sheikh. What is the relationship of the jinn and the mankind? Al-jinnati wal-nas. Look at this ayah. وَكَذَلِكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا شياطين الإنس والجن يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض زخرف القول غرورا. Look at this ayah. Allah said وكذلك likewise جعلنا لكل نبي عدو. We appointed for each نبي an enemy from شياطين الإنس and the jinn both. What they are doing, there is a relationship here. يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض. يوحي, they are inspiring each others. To what? To be enemy to Rasulullah, to the Nabi, to the Muslimin, to the Mu'mineen, to the Salihin. There is a relationship between the Shaitan al-Ins and Shaitan al-Jinn. They are inspiring each others. For example, if we talk about the fortune tellers or those who are dealing with Jinn, Sahara, or psychic, or these people, they are working for Jinn. They are giving Qurbani for Jinn. They are doing a lot of things, kufr, to the jinn. Then the jinn is working with them. Jinn will give secret talks to them, whispers to them, and telling them some information. And they carry this and give it to the human being from the, but this shaitan ins is working with shaitan al jinn. This is what they are doing. Ibn Uthaymeen said that, Ibn al-Qayyim said that, tafsir this ayah. يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض. They are inspiring each others. But الوحي here is not Sayyidina Jibreel. الوحي Jibreel, revelation. Or the Ruh al-Quds. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said also, al-wahi can be an inspiration. Like what? He said, وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ أَنِ اتَّخِذِ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا وَمِنَ الشَّجَرِ وَمِمَّا يَعْرِشُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired the bees, not through Jibreel, an inspiration. Al-Mahdi, when he's gonna come, will be inspired too. There is no Jibreel. Jibreel is not coming anymore with any book to anybody. But al-Mahdi, and the hadith of al-Mahdi is the authentic hadith, because somebody also are denying al-Mahdi and the coming of al-Mahdi, like al-Tahririyin, Tahriri sector group. They said there is no Mahdi. Who said that? Al-Mahdi is coming. It's all a hadith authentic. And it's one of the descendants of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why this, he will be inspired. Allah inspired, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَى, right? The mother of Prophet Moses. Allah said in Surah Al-Qasas, وأوحينا إلى أم موسى أن أرضعيه فإذا خفت عليه فألقيه في اليم ولا تخافي ولا تحزني إن رادوه إليك وجعله من المرسلين. فالله سبحانه وتعالى inspired the mother of موسى سيدنا عليه السلام. الله did not send جبريل to her. ففي وحي الإيه؟ وحي الإيه؟ الإيحاء, بيسموه الإيحاء or inspiration. Yeah. فthat's why the شياطين الإنس and جن, they are inspiring each others. They are helper to each others. They are telling each others what to do against the mu'mineen, against the salihin, against their enemies. This is what they are doing. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala a'la wa a'lam. ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واحفظنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا من بين ايدينا ومن خلفنا وعن ايماننا وعن شمائلنا واجعلنا لك من الشاكرين. احفظنا يا رب العالمين من شياطين الانس والجن يا رب العالمين. واحفظ اولادنا واحفظ اهلينا يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب احفظ اهلينا في غزه يا رب العالمين, احفظهم يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في غزة يا رب العالمين وفي كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين, واحقن دماءهم وكن معهم ولا تكن عليهم يا أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.